Day two started like most any other day. I woke up. The difference this time was I was in a tent and had an incredible view. This is my view from my tent as I woke up in the morning. We had been very lucky the night before when we found our last minute campsite, because only 200 yards downstream was our first Class 3 rapid, House Rock Rapid. And if we had blundered into it last night in the dark, it could have been very bad. Shane woke up early this morning and took a couple photographs. I think this one turned out great. You can see our tents in the foreground and the ominous House Rock in the background. We camped just above House Rock Rapid. Pretty inhospitable spot. Beautiful view. Morning, we're gonna hit House Rapid, a Class 3 rapids. That is right where that large rock on your left is. Excited for our first major rapid, we packed up camp, loaded our boats, and headed out. This is some video from last night I didn't put in day one. We barely got our boat in the water when it was time to scout out House Rock Rapid. The main problem is the fast water hitting the huge rock, which could easily capsize us. I got great videos of everyone running this rapid, but on day three, I take a big spill and lose my action camera. All of my videos are gone. Luckily, I did have a couple other cameras, and everyone pitched in all their photos and videos in order to make this movie. I get elected to run it first, and I run it horribly, but I do make it through. I show them what not to do. They all run it, and run it fantastically. Nice!
Yeah, whoop, whoop, whoop.
We were still playing it safe. Rich got in his boat and went downstream in case he had to catch someone's boat, while the rest of us stayed on the bank, ready to help. Because I lost my extra camera later, the only footage left of Mitch and Shane's run is the video I zoomed in from downstream on Rich's GoPro. It was overcast today and a little chilly. There was a headwind that at times blew us backwards, upstream. The river has some fast areas, followed by slow spots.
Although it was chilly, the view took our mind off the cold.
Tennessee whiskey.
With the headwind, we didn't make great time. And when we found a great spot to camp, remembering our last night's horrible camp, we took it immediately and camped early this night, about 7 o'clock. Once again, we pulled over and was covered in cockaburrs. They are everywhere.
It does something for him.
Yes, indeed it does, Captain. It makes me uncomfortable.
Campsite. Nice beach. Canyon walls all around us. Our campsite for the second night. Shane's tent. Rich and Mitch up on the grassy plateau. Shane and I are down on the beach level. Boat's just out of the water. Nice huge bar to explore. Surrounded by steep canyon walls. It's a cave. Crazy entrance to a crazy ass cave. Inside the cave. Water dripping. Here it's back a little ways. Some crazy nest here stacked with rocks. It's got grass and sticks and then covered with rocks. I'm guessing a pack rat. Pretty cool. It was nice pulling over early today. Maybe it was even 6 instead of 7. The days all ran together. We got out of our wet suits, and it felt good to put on some dry clothes. We had plenty of time to unpack our boats, set up camp, gather firewood, explore some caves, and take some pictures. The rock bar nearby had some awesome unique rocks, and I had time to do some rock hounding and found some very special specimens, although I might have paid for it later. Some of you may think this video is a little boring.
But enough about me. I hope this hasn't been boring for you. It's just that whenever I start to talk about Elaine, I always get so carried away. I lose all track of time. Well, I could go on for hours, but I'd probably start to bore you. You know, I really couldn't blame Elaine. She wanted a career. When they built those roads, they had no thought of drainage in mind. So we had to take a special jeep up to the main road In fact, we were lucky to even get a Jeep, since just the day before, only one that we had broke down. Bad act.
But let me promise you, day three, shit hits the fan. It gets crazy.
Ted, what went wrong?
The oil pressure. I forgot to check the oil pressure. When Kramer hears about this, the shit's gonna hit the fan.